Welcome, everyone, to a brand new season of NBA basketball. I'm sure you're as excited as all of us are here at 2K Sports as we get ready to start the season in style. Joined in the booth with Greg Anthony and Brent Berry, this is Kevin Harlan, our sideline reporter, David Aldridge. And this is what the schedule looks like for the Los Angeles Clippers. On Friday, they'll be playing against James Harden and the Houston Rockets. And then on Thursday, they'll be taking on Paul Millsap and the Denver Nuggets. Now the opening lineup for the Oklahoma City Thunder. Gallinari and Adams, the combo out front. Chris Paul is out there with Gilgeous Alexander. And it's Roberson in at the three, the small forward. And for the Clippers, under down low at four with Harrell in the middle. Beverly and Williams, the guard tandem. And it's George in at the small forward position. Opening night, Brent, always exciting. Technically, every team is undefeated with a lot of hope.
You're just fired up. I mean,
I am fired up.
The NBA never stops, Kevin. We know this, right?
Isn't it great, though? I'm so glad it doesn't stop.
The offseason is just absolutely ridiculously exciting.
So fun.
So much movement and hope for franchises that, have struggled for a long time. And here we go. Hope springs eternal. It's opening night.
Now, here is Gallinari. Kawhi Leonard unable to get his shot to go. He gets that one.
And Gallo knows how to finish through contact. Excellent touch from there from the big fella.
I'd send it out to David Aldridge, who caught up with head coach Billy Donovan. David?
Thanks, Kevin. I talked to him about his strategy facing this team. He said, those guys block a lot of shots, and they try to intimidate you. We have to be prepared mentally to stay aggressive, even when they send a few back our way. Guys?
Thanks, David. That's great information. We'll see if they've devised a strategy, Greg, that can get them out early.
Right. Facing such a disruptive defense poses challenges, but coach seems on it.
Yeah, I feel like the plan is there. They just got to match their opponent's intensity level.
Just setting the tone with an aggressive move to the rack, and where's the help defensively?
Are you asking me, GA? I'm not sure.
Now, here is Gallinari. Here's Adams, and he drops in the layup off the glass.
Well, Steven Adams always working the offensive glass, strong and aggressive in there, and gets that second chance hoop.
A pass to Leonard. And no good. Some solid defense from Gallinari. Kicks to Roberson. Some nice passing by Oklahoma City here. And there's the call. It's going to be an illegal screen.
When a pick like that is questionable and creates that much of an advantage for the offense, you have to blow the whistle.
Yeah, a quick little lean like that is going to get the ref's attention. Foul call.
Now here's Leonard. Gallinari with the rebound.
Still searching out their offensive game right now. 1 of 5 from the field to start this one.
Paul passes to Gilgeous Alexander. Adams dishes to Roberson. Just 5 to shoot. Here's Gilgeous Alexander. Great D that time from Leonard.
How about the timing he shows there to challenge that shot?
Yeah, not easy to do there, and that's a guy that you can tell takes every possession defensively very seriously.
And last season for the Clippers, it was a collection of smaller guys who played big.
They're very effective with those kind of lineups with shorter, very effective offensive players out there. And Lou Williams being a catalyst for what they were doing, coming off the bench and providing a spark. You know, in the fourth quarter, there was always an opportunity for the Clippers, if the game was close, to rely on Lou Williams to get the job done.
Now Harrell. After Gallinari missed from long range, 2 free throws coming up, and they call the shooting foul. That one on Gallinari.
The compliment that Harrell gets often is the fact that he's just so tireless a worker, and that energy is something that both coaching staffs and teammates appreciate.
Take a break. Take a break. 2 shots.
And that drops, so they now lead by 1.
Take a
about Montrezl Harrell and the type of energy and effort that he brought last year to this team to help solidify, I guess, most of the culture piece of what Steve Ballmer wants this franchise to be about. That's playing hard, playing with energy, and having some enthusiasm for the competition. Montrezl Harrell wraps all those things up pretty nicely in the way he plays.
And Montrezl Harrell, Brent, beloved in the locker room.
Well, he's beloved because every night when you go out on the floor with him, you know what you're going to get. A guy who is incredibly competitive, passionate, knows his role, and plays with a physical presence that he doesn't shy away from anybody that's on the floor. That's infectious.
And here is Los Angeles now, following the score by Oklahoma City. Ball against Beverly. A three ball. The Thunder pull it in. Up top, Gilgeous Alexander, defended by Beverly. Fades. Offensive rebound. And the rejection by Leonard.
And that's the thing we know about Leonard. As a defender, on the ball, off the ball, he's rarely out of any play.
And here is Harrell. Shamet with it. Here's Leonard. And it's Noel with the rebound.
Not really his best quarter as far as scoring. Let's see if he can eventually get back on track.
Paul finds Noel. Now, Gilgeous Alexander. He is defended by Harrell. And the three ball is good.
Well, proving more and more he's trying to be more effective from the three-point line as Gilgeous Alexander collects a bucket.
Paul with the steal. Fast break. Here we go. And that one drops.
Special. There just aren't many guys like him who can accelerate to the rim and finish in style.
Pass to Harrell. Back to Beverly. Outside, George. Pass to Shamet. Outside, Leonard. Rocket six. It's George on the wing. To end the drought. And that's good for two.
That's a reliable offensive option right there. Shooting with consistency as Paul George can get you from a number of spots.
The shot and game clock separated by four. 2 points. That one goes. Gilgeous Alexander's got 7 points in the game.
Not just the accuracy in the quarter, it's his movement and the energy that's getting him on this nice roll.
From deep, George. The shot, no good. And we reach the end of the first quarter. It's the Thunder up by six. Don't go anywhere, folks. We'll be back in just a moment. Chris Paul, an elite defensive player, a student of the game for sure, talks about his knack for making a lot of steals, forcing turnovers.
The steals thing is just something that I've always had a knack for doing, and just I think it's because I watch so much basketball.
Well, you hear about the importance of watching film, Greg. It reveals itself in many ways.
And learning guys' habits, what they like to do, gives him a knack for when to go after steals without hurting his team.
And thanks again for tuning in. If you're just joining us, we've played through one quarter of action so far. What stands out to you from Oklahoma City in this one?
I mean, the rebounding was the difference in that first period. You've got to block these guys out.
Yeah, rebounding can also be just about will, and they showed some of that in going in there and collecting some boards.
Shamet and George at the two and the three. Jermichael Green is out there with Ivica Zubac, and it's Beverly in at the one spot. That's who's out there for the Clippers. It's his first trip to the line.
Had a success rate from the line last year of about 78%.
Shooting two.
The first free throw is good. If you were choosing a center for the team that you ran, and you've got these options, Joel Embiid, Big Cat, or Jokic in Denver, who do you go with?
So much variety in their games, Kevin. And I appreciate what Jokic does so much for that Denver Nuggets offense, initiating as a center from the top. But I'm going to have to go with Embiid and the way that he can dominate the game. There's still so much potential and growth for what it is that he can do. Down on the block, doing damage, taking away a lot of three-point shots. Not to disparage what it is that Karl Anthony Towns can do, but his size and dominance, I think there's an intimidation factor that Joel Embiid brings to the game that I would lean on over the other two.
To the middle, here's Zubac, and the dunk by Zubac.
Going to the rack with energy, and the D afraid to cut him off.
Yeah, gotta chalk that one up to some shaky defending.
There's some ways to get your coach's attention, and that draws the coaching staff's ire.
Now, here's Gallinari. Pass to Muscala. Schroeder outside. And a miss there on the triple.
Having a hand up in your face makes such a difference to a shooter.
Yeah, as good as you can do without getting a block there to defend.
That was big because they dug a big hole in the first quarter, but starting to show signs of life. Well, for so much of what Paul George brings to the table, you have to start with his defensive impact. He is one of the top defenders in the league at his position, if not the best.
Lou Williams has checked in for the Clippers. Then for the Thunder, Adams, he's checked in for Nerlens Noel, and it's Roberson in for Muscala.
One shot.
And that one misses. You look at George with all he does, Greg, you sometimes forget how good his perimeter defense is.
Well, I mean, his teammates and coaches won't ever forget about the impact he has on that end. Even when George isn't scoring or the shot isn't falling, he is still a monster on the floor just with his defense alone.
Now, here is George over Roberson, and it's all evened up. 6 points for George.
His range goes out a lot further, but didn't need to on that possession.
The pass to Schroeder. Here's Adams. Shamit with the steal. And now the fast break. George with the ball. Got it for his fourth field goal of the game on just 5 shots.
Seemed to be laying in the weeds there in the first quarter, but now we're seeing him
timeout,
put all the cards on the table, and ramp it up.
Timeout is called. First of the game for the Thunder. And a huge piece of the Tobias Harris trade last year, Brent, Landry Shamit, shows a lot of promise.
Yeah, interesting for Lambeau, as they call him, at age 22 out of Wichita State, to come into the league, show his ability to shoot from the three-point line, shot 40% from deep while taking over four a game last year, seemed very comfortable in seeking out the line. And the opportunity for him now with the star power around him, a lot more is going to open up for Landry Shamit to be a third or fourth guy on the offensive end to make some major contributions.
No one had more success at the foul line last season than this group of players. Gallinari, fourth.
He was locked and loaded from the free throw line all season. Never suffered through any real lulls in that department.
Here in the second quarter, we've played a little over 2.5 minutes now. Schroeder passes to Ferguson. Back to Schroeder. Shot clock at 5. Here's the teardrop. And Adams kicks to Gallinari. Kicks it out to Schroeder. They need this. Krills it from outside. Schroeder's got himself going there. His first points of the game on the deep ball. And so it's Williams who brings it up for the Los Angeles Clippers. They've only allowed 5 points in the quarter. Shamit finds Williams. Basket counts. Williams has got his first 2 points of the night.
Yeah, they're going to have a nice little run here.
Pass to Gallinari. And oh boy, a lot of contact there, but he gets the call and will shoot two. Well, when Danilo Gallinari came into the NBA, Brent, he was just a catch-and-shoot type player. But he's so much more than that now.
Well, I think with the way the league has changed with the three-point shot and Gallinari's ability to do that, he's gotten a lot smarter about picking his spots when the pump fake can drive in and draw some contact.
First free throw is good. The defensive rules were different when you played, Brent. For example, the elimination of the handshake.
Handshaking was huge because great defensive guards like a Derek Harper or a Mookie Blaylock could get their forearm on you and basically move you around rather than you trying to get where you want to go. And the other thing, Kevin, that they did was they didn't allow you to have the time in the free throw line. You have a 2.9 before an illegal defense. It used to be a game, really, of two stars on one side of the floor operating, and the rest of the guys sort of shoveled off in the corner on the other side. All those things have changed with the way the league has gone.
For the better.
Oh, I think so. Yeah, yes. Freedom of movement, yes. Fluidity of the athletes. It's definitely a better game in terms of the movement.
Back to Williams. On deep. The rebound by Steven Adams. Adams has got his fourth rebound with that last one here tonight. Back to Paul. 1:31 left in the first half of basketball. And that one is good. Paul's got his second bucket tonight.
That's why Chris Paul is so special, is because he can just navigate around pick and rolls, find open areas, and there's just no defense for that.
Now here's Leonard. Leonard on the wing. Over Robertson. Yep, it goes, and the Oklahoma City lead is cut to just one on the basket from Kawhi Leonard.
Leonard did a good job to take a picture there, recognizing what was going on, read the defense, and then finds a soft spot in the mid-range.
Here's Adams. Here's Gallinari. Adams trying to free himself up. And he battles for the ball and gets the second chance bucket.
You don't want to ever give up points on the boards. That's the lesson for the team there. That's a hustle play to save points.
Passes it to Leonard. Williams against Paul. Pass to Harrell. Los Angeles needs to get off a shot here. Offensive rebound. Outside Williams. Let's a floater go, and it's good on the layup. Williams has got 4 points now in the quarter.
Well, you deserve that kind of treatment if you're going to get up with Lou Williams like that. Terrific at getting to the rack.
Here's Gilgeous Alexander, and the last shot at the buzzer doesn't go in for him. So that'll be it for the first half. Fairly even battle underway in this one. Thunder lead by one. And a chance now to send it over to David Aldridge, standing by courtside. David.
Hey, Kevin, thank you. Kawhi, a big first half for you all offensively, but big first half for them, too. Any concern there?
They're still scoring pretty good, so we got to play better defense second half because we don't know if we're going to keep making the shots that we're making right now.
We'll see who can get some stops, Kawhi. Thank you. Back to you, Kevin.
Okay, David, much appreciated. And now time for halftime. So we'll be back in just a bit to get the third quarter underway.
The 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Ernie Johnson here with Shaq and Kenny, and a favorite time of the year as we're halfway through one of the first games of this fresh NBA season. Oklahoma City has the edge here at halftime. They lead by one. Kenny?
You have to love a team that pounds the offensive glass. That's going to gain you extra possessions. And check this out. Sometimes just having more offensive chances than your opponent wins the basketball game.
Shaq, what was your takeaway on the Clippers?
Well, as we know, it's always a good idea to pound the ball into the paint. So many defensive game plans are focused just on stopping the three. When you hurt a team down low, they got to react. That allows you to play inside out. Trust me, I have the blueprint. I own the blueprint. I created the blueprint. Inside, kick it back out, shoot the three. Rick Fox, Big Shaw, and Big Shot, Bob for three. The crowd going crazy. I know you remember that, Andy.
And it's just about time now for the third quarter to get underway.
And as we get into this third quarter, as we've seen so far, neither team able to create much separation on the scoreboard yet. Without question, George is displaying his skills today.
Well, we'll find out if they were able to find an answer for him over the break. He was scoring with ease in that first half.
Yeah, just way too easy out there, and I'm sure Coach is going to make that a priority at halftime.
And after a fairly even first couple of quarters, the second half could turn out to be a great one as both teams try to gain an edge. And on the floor for Billy Donovan as we get into the second half. Robertson and Gallinari at the small and power forward positions. Gilgeous Alexander out there with Paul, and it's Adams in at the five spot.
Well, a look at that 2018 Clippers draft pick and Gilgeous Alexander. His incredible size at the point guard spot makes him one of the more intriguing players from that class.
First trip to the line for him here.
Shooting two.
And he can't get the first one. And last season with Gilgeous Alexander, Greg, you could see what he was capable of with his length.
Well, he is just so difficult to slow up when he's running downhill at a defender. Already a plus defender in his offense coming along, he could be a scary figure at that point guard position.
And he sinks the second.
Such a long and versatile guard that possesses a very intriguing and exciting skill set. Gilgeous Alexander, lots of room to grow.
Now here's Williams. Teardrop shot, and Adams sends it back. Now here's Gilgeous Alexander. D right on him. He kicks to Paul. Leonard with the steal. Dishes it to Beverly. Now the pass to Harrell. Pass to Williams. Now here's Leonard. Five to shoot. For the lead. Gallinari with the rebound. Gallinari's got his fifth rebound right now in the game. And wrestling for it there, but no one has possession. We'll have a jump ball. And here is Los Angeles now. And so Beverly will bring it up for Los Angeles. In the second half, they've only given up one basket coming from the free throw line. Passes it to Leonard. For the tie. And the rebound goes to the Thunder. Gallinari's got six rebounds here tonight.
Not been an easy start. Three straight misses here on these possessions.
Man, can you always depend on him or what to lead you to the right place with that pass? Money.
You know, Greg, for the Thunder fans, hard to see their star power dwindle, but they got a lot in return.
Yeah, but the Thunder were capped out. They hadn't made it past the first round in 3 years. And in exchange for Paul George, they got one of the richest trade packages in league history.
Here's Paul. Kawhi Leonard making his last shot. And the call is going to be... Yes, it is. An illegal screen.
And now let's take a look at Kawhi Leonard. He's coming off an excellent season. Sixth in scoring. And, of course, he's got a nose for the ball. He ranked in the top 10 in steals last season.
And back to his points per game average last year. He literally propped up the team's offense whenever they needed it. Now, here's Beverly. Here's Leonard. And that one goes long.
I wonder what the score would be if they weren't controlling the backboard.
Roberson dishes to Adams, and Adams with the slam.
Well, this is what Steven Adams does. He finds his way into the paint for high percentage shots just like that.
They've been looking out of sync offensively.
Yeah, their offense has ground to a standstill.
Now here's Harrell. Let's it go from 14. That's it, and the Oklahoma City lead is cut down to just 2 points in the bucket from Williams.
Pretty good mid-range player there. The touch from Lou Williams, especially in those kind of jumpers, that one's on the money.
Time called here. The Thunder decide to talk it over. Greg, I'm just so impressed with the level of finesse and craftiness that Lou Williams always plays with.
And, Kevin, you don't stay a perennial six-man of the year candidate at Williams' age without having more than a few tricks up your sleeve. He's so good in tight spaces and can find a way to get a shot up where others just have to kick it out.
Catching up on the changes for Los Angeles, Zubats is checked in for Harrell, and Landry Shamet subbed in for Lou Williams. And a new group getting ready for Oklahoma City. Maryland's Noel checks in for Adams. Mike Muscala comes in for Gallinari. Ferguson's checked in for Roberson. And Dennis Schroeder subbed in for Chris Paul. And the Clippers making a switch here. Green's checked in. Here's Schroeder. Just five on the clock. Puts one up from 19. And again, Oklahoma City, no good. The Clippers trail. Just over 3.5 minutes through the third quarter of play now. Beverly, the pass to Zubats.
Well, last season, maybe not a lot talked about with regards to how it is that the Oklahoma City team played defensively. Now, that's coming on the foundation of Paul George on the perimeter, so somebody's going to have to step up in that void. But it was a strength of their team, and we'll see if these other players in these roles can make sure they consistently stay good on that end of the floor.
That one is off. And he's good on the second. Here's Schroeder.
He's got Dennis.
Pass to Noel. Now, here's Gilgeous Alexander. Zubats defending. And the rejection by Zubats. For the lead, Leonard attacking, and he sinks the layup. Leonard's got 4 points this quarter. And Brent, going back to the defense, as the Thunder have lost some of their top scorers, guarding, defending has become a major emphasis.
Yeah, I think it's an interesting time in Oklahoma City for a lot of teaching to get done with these players who are going to have an opportunity to play minutes they have not played before. They look for length and athleticism and hopefully find some guys that have a defensive upside.
Neither side has relented a bit in this back-and-forth affair.
And you can sense the energy in the building already as this game is starting to build towards having a terrific finish.
And he gets it back, and he uses the glass on the layup. Leonard's got 12. And so it's Schroeder with the ball. He'll bring it up for the Thunder. Bounce pass from Gilgeous Alexander. Here's Ferguson, guarded by Green. Ferguson misses.
Oh, that's terrific defense there. That's how you protect the rim.
Beverly lays it up off the glass. Beverly's got the lead up to three now for the Clippers.
And of the last six baskets, five have come on the interior. This is just smash-mouth physical basketball, guys.
Now here's Schroeder. 5 points in the game. And slam dunk by Noel.
And trust me, Dennis Schroeder would love to score the basketball, but his ability to set up his teammates is also effective.
Now 8 seconds separating the two clocks. And finished off by Leonard.
Oh, an aggressive move and fantastic finish.
Trying to send a message with that slam, I think. Beverly against Schroeder. And the last second attempt does not go in for him.
I think Patrick Beverley loves the challenge every night to shut down his man. Takes great pride on the defensive end.
We're at the end of the third, and we've still got a close one. The Clippers on top. They lead by three. And fourth quarter basketball will be coming your way on 2K Sports right after this. Let's take a listen to a recent huddle from Coach Billy Donovan.
Hold your ground. Don't let him back your way in. Just hold your ground. The other thing, too, is once he picks the ball up, he's not going to shoot it. If he does, just stay down on him.
I like the way that Donovan's conveying that scouting report to his guys.
I mean, knowing how your opponent plays is important, and I think he's on point on this one.
3/10 quarters behind us. One more to go. Thanks for being with us as we begin the fourth. Shamet Leonard around the wing. Ivica Zubac is out there with Jermichael Green, and it's Beverly in a point guard. That's who's out there for the Clippers. Here's Schroeder. Kawhi Leonard making his last shot, and that one's good. Noel.
Great to have Noel active like that, proving how dangerous he can be on the inside.
Leonard on the wing. Back to Beverly. Makes it off the glass.
And they're beginning to just flat out fall apart defensively right now, especially on the interior.
Thunder trailing by five. Schroeder finds Gallinari. And we've played through about a minute here in the fourth. And the foul called on Kawhi Leonard. That is his first foul of the game. A different look for the Clippers. Montrezl Harrell, he's checked in for Jermichael Green. Paul George comes in for Kawhi Leonard. Lou Williams is subbed in for Landry Shamet. Then for the Thunder, Adams comes in for Noel. And it's Paul in for Dennis Schroeder. Now here's Adams. Muscala dishes to Paul. Five on the clock. Oklahoma City needs to get off a shot. Here's Roberson. Sinks it. What range from outside. Wow.
Well, no hesitation from Roberson that time. Got his shot off quickly as soon as he got the ball.
Here's Beverly. Oh, and there's the one-handed jam.
Big hops from the backcourt.
Oh, absolutely. And maybe just what they need to get this game, GA, going in their direction.
Defense has got to be better. Flat out effort was not there.
Williams with the steal. To the paint. Here's Zubac. And contact on the shot, so he'll be shooting free throws here.
And you don't ever want to get into the habit of letting the offense get to the rim.
The free throw drops for Zubac. He hits both from the stripe. And so it's Oklahoma City with it. They trail by six. Following this one, they get to host the Mavericks. That game is the first and last of their homestand. Paul outside. Down to five on the shot clock. Williams with the steal. To the inside. And that one clearly a foul. Gets the whistle and two shots coming up.
Such a difficult cover for any defense. Lou Williams is adept at putting the defense in uneasy situations, backing them up quite a bit.
He misses the free throw.
And thinking back to last postseason, the Clippers did not back down to the Warriors at all.
Well, L.A. was a much more physical team. I think they knew going in that the only way that they had a shot was to be disruptive, and they brought that on both ends of the floor, and that was going against a healthy Kevin Durant. at the time. They took two games last year in that series, and the way in which they played, that spirit might have caught the attention of one Paul George and one Kawhi Leonard.
And Brett, even though the Thunder have come up short in recent years, they are looking to the future as their time.
Well, interesting the way that Sam Presti went about his business in the offseason, trading away Russell Westbrook and then collecting so many draft picks. I can't even count them, but what a great way for them to rebuild and revamp in Oklahoma City.
Well, we're now on the back end of what has been, Greg, an incredible career for Chris Paul. Perhaps no longer the undisputed best point guard in the game, but still a top talent.
And Chris Paul might not be the best point guard, but any team would be happy to have him. His efficiency and playmaking aren't going away anytime soon. And even though he's never been an overly athletic player, that aspect of his game still as strong as ever.
First one falls for him.
And the Clippers franchise joined this league in 1970. They've never made it past the conference semifinals.
Yeah, but the last few years, when you talk about the landscape of Los Angeles, the Clippers have had a remarkable run, much better record than the Lakers have had in Tinseltown. And so surprising to think of all the talent that's come through the Clipper doors in prior years, but this could be the year with these additions where they break through.
Now here's Williams. Now here is George. And foul on the shot. He'll shoot two at the free throw line. And perhaps the most shocking news of the NBA offseason, Greg, the trade of Paul George. Nobody saw that coming.
Took a ransom of draft picks to get him off the Thunder. Kawhi Leonard recruited him to join him on the Clippers, and Paul obliged by demanding a trade. Came together quickly and caused a major power shift in the West.
That free throw good from George.
With Paul George, it's pretty awesome. You get the whole package. You get great scoring. You get good playmaking and rebounding. You get a defender with active hands. There's a lot of things about Paul George that can elevate everything you do to have great team success.
And both free throws good for Paul George.
And for Coach Billy Donovan of the Thunder, a lot on the line. In his last year of a five-year contract with the team, the end result of this team will determine his future with the franchise.
Well, this team has never missed the playoffs under his watch. And the interesting thing with the massive trades that happened in the offseason, how much Billy Donovan gets the opportunity now to teach and coach this group of players. He may not be the strongest inside presence in the league, but still, he's got to convert from there.
Beverly deciding where to go with it. Plays it up and banks it in.
They're finding lanes to the hoop now with consistency. Five buckets in a row from the paint.
Ball against George. The offensive rebound, and Adams with the slam.
That's what he gives you, a big-time presence on the glass.
And you know what, Greg? Once he gets his hands on it, he's not even thinking about kicking it out.
Oh, his competitiveness right now is why the teammates love him.
And the Clippers call time here.
And he could tell his guys starting to wear down a little bit. Call time to just let them get their legs back under them.
Chance now to recognize our Jordan player of the game, Kawhi Leonard.
And to me, the best part of his game has been the work he's done inside. I mean, slashing, driving the lane, attacking the basket at every chance. When he's had an opening, he's taken it.
He sure has given this crowd a treat tonight. This kind of performance only cements his status as a fan favorite. Okay, well, let's go down to David Aldridge for a report from the sideline.
Hey, Kevin, during the last break, I heard Doc Rivers talking with his team. He told them, this is a game of runs. It's a game of momentum. You may have the lead now, but I'm telling you guys, it can evaporate in a hurry. Let's close this thing out.
Time out.
If Paul George doesn't mind tight defense, I think he can get around them, and he maintains some great ball-handling mechanics, even with the guy in his face.
Now a timeout called by Oklahoma City. They're down by nine. 1:58 left in the fourth quarter. Paul against Beverly. Paul right side. Over Beverly. They get it again. Adams shakes off the strong D and gets to the bucket for two. Adams has got 4 points in the quarter. Paul against Beverly. Pulls up. High post. Again, Los Angeles.
He just takes advantage of the D in a way that very few players, Kevin, playing today can do.
Now, here's Gilgeous Alexander. He's guarded by Williams. Guys, a good chance for them to slow it down.
Yeah, they definitely should use some clock here.
Here's Leonard. And a lot of contact on that one, so he'll shoot two here. Steven Adams picks one up.
Good scorers have that ability. When Leonard gets that deep, it's usually a bucket, a trip to the free throw line, or both.
Gets the first, and that'll push the lead to double digits.
Well, the wingspan and the timing that Kawhi Leonard has is really remarkable. He utilizes those strengths to dominate both ends of an NBA floor.
All free throws good from Kawhi Leonard. And Gilgeous Alexander's got the ball here for the Thunder. There's the dish to Paul. And that'll be two free throws coming up. Officials on the call with the foul. It's on Kawhi Leonard.
Love how Paul angles his body when he feels that contact and then pushes off and draws the foul every time.
Shooting two.
He's off on the first.
This is an area where Chris Paul has been solid every year, always right around 90% from the charity stripe.
Second of two is good. That brings them to within 10.
A disappointing trip to the line there. Even though it was just one miss, now is not the time to be missing those.
Now here's Williams. Outside Leonard. A beautiful reverse layup. Leonard's got the lead up to 12 now for the Clippers.
Making every effort to put this game on ice.
Loved it. The guys are staying aggressive late in this ball game, just not wanting to let go of the rope.
Here's Los Angeles now. They're on a 17-7 run. So the Clippers winning this one easily. A confident win and one where they clearly showed the greater effort.
Yeah, I mean, it was a solid performance, particularly here at home. And I think they built off that edge of being here and playing with just a little more confidence than their opponent.
It's time now to go courtside as we send you over to David Aldridge from the sideline. David, take it away.
Thanks very much. Paul, obviously your team is built on defense. It seems like that's a big part of this team's identity.
We take pride in our defense. At the end of the day, that's what we hang our hats on, is locking down when it counts. And we stayed together and pulled this one up.
Great team effort tonight, Paul. Thanks very much. Back to you, Kevin.
All right, David. Great job. Thanks so much. Well, folks, that's going to do it for now. For Brett Berry, Greg Anthony, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan along with our 2K Sports crew. We'll see you later.